Well, I'm in charge of talking to you about academia, mathematics in academia, which probably you will think that it reduces to just what you see, your teachers, your lecturers, teachers at high school or the lecturers at university teaching you whatever math you studied. So let me, okay, I'm scrolling the slides. Let me present myself. I finished my PhD long time ago in 2006 and became a fellow of the Higher Education Academy in 2018. It's one of the requisites that that are needed for the for teaching in UK. It's not common in the rest of the world, but depending on the country, you will have some requisites to degrees or some kind of certifications that you need to teach in different countries, depends on the country. And I'm a member of several societies, mathematical societies. RSME is the Royal Spanish Mathematical Society. IMA is meant for Spanish, there S for society. LMS is the London Mathematical Society and the European Mathematical Society. I'm a fellow of the IMA. And a member, and now these two next things are very much what I want to point on my time for the presentation of mathematics in academia. I'm a member of the gender equality committees at the Royal Spanish Mathematical Society, and at the institute is ICMAT, is the National Institute of Mathematics in Spain. I'm also evaluator for the European Research Council and other councils, I mean, other research councils. It means that I do research, apart from my teaching, I do research, and I'm evaluator for research of other people, for my peers. And also I have the other side of the impact that you can have in society, that is some things like activism, in this case is gender equality. I'm also an activist in LGBT issues and so on. And you can do many other things. And also all these things, you have to think that they influence in your teaching and your research. For instance, I'm a writer, I like very much to write, and then I wrote about geometry and the influences in other sciences, like in physics, that is very easy influence to think about, but also in philosophy or in art. And I like these kind of things, and it's very, very much possible when you are doing your work in academia, because actually universities like you to do these kind of things. I'm also a musician. I'm thinking now on a book about mathematics and music, and there are many books like that, but you know, I want to put my small piece of sand in the whole beach, you know? Well, how do you get to be a professor in mathematics? It's a long path, I must say. Plenty of diversions and so on. But for first thing that you have to do is to start with your PhD thesis. That's the beginning, that's for sure. Then there is a time that you have to do some postdoctoral training where you at the same time you're fighting for a position. For instance, this postdoctoral training could be in a very prestigious university, that's what you wish. I did some postdoctoral training in Oxford, for instance, in Max Planck in Germany. You look for the best places where you, after that, you are counting that these places will serve you as a launching place for your rest of your academic career. And then when you find a position, when you become a professor, a lecturer at university, then a very, very new life and a very busy life starts for you. Because then the university expects you a lot of maturity and you being able to do a lot of things. So they will expect you to do your research, to do your teaching, and also to be committed to improve the research and teaching of your university. So then you have to be able to work in teams. So all these skills that everybody thinks that are only useful for the companies and so on are also useful and important in academia. It's not that you are in your ivory tower and you don't think about everything else. It's like you have to work in teams. You have to understand the world. You are in the middle of the world. But at university, for instance, you about the impact, you will be able also sometimes your university will encourage you to start a startup, to start your own small company. Also, they will be very much interested in you to work, write books on research or books on you know, outreach to explain to the general public what you are doing, your pieces of research. You will be giving talks about maths and about how maths is used in the rest of the areas. And also you will use your position as a lecturer, a professor at university to make some influence. I mean, because at the end of the day, you are talking to many, many, many people. Many, many people is going to see you as someone that has some kind of authority. So it's something that you have to take very much into account and be very, very respectful about that, because there's a lot of students that I see every year, and how I speak to them is part of the influence that I'm doing in society. It's something that is important. About my research, that's a nice thing that I have to very much say it with a lot of weight. I don't know how I can say it with enough weight. That is, in academia and university, you are not pressured, but what are the results? So you can do some pure mathematics just for the need of doing this pure mathematics. Meaning that, for instance, I do math and physics. So my research combines math and physics, and specifically in physics is very much related to string theory. Everybody has heard about the string theory. You know? What I think that is important there is that I don't have the pressure of a company asking me for some results that will be giving some kind of specifically output that will be some profit for the company. That's very much needed that somebody is doing this, because what I'm doing now maybe is not of a profit tomorrow, but is going to be of profit in 50 years. A good example is, for instance, the theory of algebraic curves that now is, well, now is even outdated, because it is on the basis of how CD players were done. Without algebraic curves, you don't have CD players. So imagine, without algebraic curves and how to implement some special structures like fractals, maybe you don't have the 5G right now. So that's what the pure and very basic science is about. So it's very much needed, always. I cannot say it strongly enough. Well, the good thing and the funny part of doing research and teaching in academia is that then you travel a lot. That's one of the most enjoying parts of the work. I put some places that I like to go, and I go often, which are the Simon Center, which is in Long Island in next to New York. Oxford is a beautiful place to go. American Institute of Mathematics is in California. ICTS is in Mumbai. Well, there are several ICTS, one in Bangalore, another one in Mumbai. There is Isaac Newton for Mathematics is in Cambridge. Max Planck Institutes are all around Germany. There are many places that you will have collaborators and you will have friends. Actually, I will say that I have a big family of people that I can always talk with. And now with COVID, it was very, very nice to be able to collaborate with people around the world and ask and talk and even, you know, develop some tiny models to understand what was going on and understand what is the world about. And just to stress my main point is that within academia, you can always do a lot of things. It only depends on what is your imagination about, because you can be based on, okay, you have to do your teaching, you have to do your research, but first, math does not only belongs to mathematics departments, not even within the university, because you can be a mathematician in the biology department, you can be a mathematician in the faculty of medicine, or you can be a mathematician even in the faculty of law. They will need you. And your duties could span far beyond just your teaching and research, as I was saying at the beginning. Here, a big example is this guy here is Roger Penrose, who won a Nobel Prize just recently. Here, you must know him, is Marcus du Sautoy, who has a programming or had a program in the BBC at some point. He even has a theater play. And that's the kind of things. Your university will always support you to do more, always, like any company, I would say, no? But the university is committed with growing of knowledge by itself. So that's something that is very nice for a mathematician to join with. And that's what I wanted to tell you.